أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بفضل الله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا سيد الأنام وصفوة الأنبياء الكرام المحمود الأحمد أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين لا سيما بقية الله في الأراضين وحجته على العالمين الحجة ابن الحسن فداه أرواح العالمين واللعن على أعدائهم أبد الآبدين ودهر الداهرين قال الله العظيم في كتابه الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الأخلاء يومئذ بعضهم لبعض عدو إلا المتقين أمنا بالله صدق الله العلي العظيم Please recite aloud صلوات على محمد وآل محمد I'm pretty sure that nobody will doubt in the importance of friend. And everyone, every single one here and everywhere has got friends. And we need friends. As Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi says, أعجز الناس العاجز عن أن يحصل على الصديق. The most unfortunate person is someone who cannot find a friend. And someone who is more miserable than that is someone who got the friend, but he lose them because of his deeds, his bad deeds towards them. We need a friend. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, and Imam Sadiq mentions that ayah to demonstrate the importance of a friend. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَا لَنَا مِنْ شَافِعِينَ وَلَا صَدِيقٍ حَمِيمٍ In hell, even in hell, people will say, we don't have someone to be our shafi' while we are in hell. And we don't have any friend who can help us, takes us out of hell. So we need friends. We cannot live without friends. I'm not talking about classmates, workmates, friends, someone who you can rely upon, who you can live with, who you can travel with, who you can sometimes tell him some of your secrets. Even if you got parents, even if you got brothers, if your brother is not your friend, you cannot tell him your what is going on between you and others, what is going on into your heart. You can't tell him your problems. But sometimes you got a friend, he's even more close to you than your brothers, than your parents. And that's why we need a friend and we need good friends. Quran al-Kareem and Ahlul Bayt alayhum as-salam says that friends are very important, but you have to choose them correctly. If you go with someone who is not suitable for you to go with, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam says, Al-mar'u ala dini khalilih. If you want to know the religion of someone, see the religion of his friend or his friends. That's it. He will be like them, for sure. I'm not saying that he will be like his classmates. No, friends. Someone who you can tell your secret to him, who you can live with him, who you love to travel with him, to be with him. That person is your friend. Al-akhillau yawma'idhin ba'duhum liba'din adu illa al-muttaqeen. One day the friendship will break up. When? And the day of judgment. Unless if you build your friendship on piousness, on taqwa. Otherwise, it will end up. Don't tell me that you're going to be with your friend up to the end of your life and in hereafter, you're going to be with him. No. You either lose him in this world, and if he, you or him are not muttaqi, you will lose him in the day of judgment. Not only lose him, you will actually take him as an enemy. Al-akhillā'u yawma'idhin ba'duhum liba'din adu illa al-muttaqin. They will enemy. They will end up as an enemy. That's bad. Why should I live with someone for 40 years? Take him as a friend, and the day of judgment, I will take him as my enemy? Why? Why should I do that? We believe in the day of judgment. Of course, we have to believe in it. There is no cause in this world without believing in the day of judgment. أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجِعُونَ. Do you think that we have created you for no reason? And do you believe that there is no day of judgment, day of resurrection? You are totally wrong. So why should I take a friend? Well, I need a friend. Take a friend that he cannot stand for me, that he cannot help me, that he cannot benefit me, and sometimes he will harm me. Al-akhillā'u yawma'idhin ba'duhum liba'din adu illa al-muttaqin. Imam al-Hasan al-Mujtaba, and we are commemorating the birthday of him. Imam al-Hasan al-Mujtaba says in one of his wills and wasiyya, Ya bunayya, la tuwakhi ahadan hatta ta'rifa mawaridahu wa masadirah. فَإِذَا اسْتَبْطَنْتَ الْخُبْرَةِ وَرَضِيْتَ الْعِشْرَةِ فَآخِهِ عَلَىٰ إِقَالَةِ الْعِثْرَةِ أَوْ إِقَالَةِ الْعَثْرَةِ وَالْمُوَاسَاتِ فِي الْعُسْرَةِ. Do not take someone as your close friend. He's talking about close friend. Al-Ikha. When Ahlul Bayt alayhum salam wants to talk about close friend, they say his, your brother. Do not take someone as your brother. It means your close friend. Unless if you examine him, how he is living, what is his job, where he is going, is he going to mosque or elsewhere? Is he studying or doing other things? Is he pleased? Is his parents pleased with him, or they are not pleased with him? They are angry with him. That's important. That's important. Once, I believe a riwayah, a narration, someone lost his friend, or he wanted to marry a woman. He came to Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam. I want to marry a woman, but her parents are not very pleased with her. Do you think I should marry her? Imam al-Sadiq said, no. Do not marry her. And he replied, she is very beautiful. I really want to marry her. Imam Sadiq replied, do not marry her, because you're not going to see any goodness of her. Because if someone's parent are angry with him or her, they're not going to be happy in this world. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's laws. So try to examine him. Where does he go? Who he hangs out with? Who he got as a friend? And if you see that he's okay, take him as a friend. Not only take him as a friend and as your brother, but tell him, listen, listen, mate, I'd like to be not only your friend, I'd like to be, alaykum salam wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh, I'd like to be your brother. And under this condition, if anything happens to you, I will stand up for you. If anything happens to me, I want you to stand up for me. فَآخِهِ عَلَىٰ إِقَالَةِ الْعَثْرَةِ وَالْمُوَاسَاتِ فِي الْعُسْرَةِ If things gets difficult for us, he will sacrifice for me, I will sacrifice for him. If I see something wrong from him, or he sees something wrong from me towards him, he can accept my apology. Tell him that under this condition, I'd like to be your brother and I'd like you to be my brother. Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam says in a narration in Nahj al-Balagha, Ya Bunay, he tells Imam al-Hasan al-Mushtaba, O my son, Imam Hassan, Iyaka wa musadaqat al-Ahmaq, fa'innahu yuridu an yanfa'aka fayadhurrak. Do not make friendship with a fool, because when he wants to benefit you, actually he harms you. So why should I take a fool person as a friend? Iyaka wa musadaqat al-bakhil. That other thing. If you want to make a friend, to find a friend, find a generous one, not a scrooge one, not someone who is close-handed. Iyaka wa musadaqat al-bakhil, fa innahu yaq'udu anka ahwaja ma takuna ilayh. When you need him, he will abandon you. He will leave you. So why take someone as a friend while he is not generous? He is bakhil. Iyaka wa musadaqat al-fajr. Vicious person. Do not take him as a friend. Why? لَأَنَّهُ يَبِيعَكَ بِالرَّخِيصِ فَإِنَّهُ يَبِيعُكَ بِالتَّافِحِ He sells you for no price. فَشَرَوْهُ بِدَمْ نَعَمْ بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسٍ دَرَاهِمَ مَعْدُودَةٍ Yusuf, as-Siddiq, the prophet, son of a prophet, they sold him for nothing. Few bucks. فَشَرَوْهُ بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسٍ دَرَاهِمَ مَعْدُودَةٍ Even in dunya, they had the opportunity to sell him for best prices, but they sold him for nothing. فَشَرَوْهُ بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسْ دَرَاهِمَ مَعْدُودَ A few bucks, $10, it's nothing. إِيَّاكَ وَمُصَادَقَتْ الْفَاجِرْ فَإِنَّهُ يَبِيعُكَ بِالتَّافِحِ إِيَّاكَ وَمُصَادَقَتِ الْكَذَّابِ فَإِنَّهُ كَالسَّرَابِ يُقَرِّبُ عَلَيْكَ الْبَعِيدِ وَيُبَعِّدُ عَلَيْكَ الْقَرِيبِ Do not take a liar as your friend, because he's like a mirage. He shows you things that are very far away from you, tells you that, no, that's easy. Enter and come in this business. You will see the prophet very soon. Actually, you're not going to see any prophets. You're not going to make any profits. Sometimes you might reach your goal easily. But he tells you when you ask him, should I enter this business? Should I go and study this course, this unit? He replies, no, just leave it. You're not going to benefit from it. Although he knew that, he knows that, your friend knows that, you will benefit from this course, from this unit, from this business, from this school, from this university. Why he is saying that? Because he's a liar. So if someone is a liar, do not take him as your friend. He's only your classmate, workmate, nothing more than that. If he's vicious, if he's a liar, if he's fool and ahmaq, do not take him as your brother and your close friend. Al-akhillau yawma'idhin ba'duhum li-ba'dhin adu illa al-muttaqeen. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the opportunity to make good friends and to be with them up to the end of our lives and in the day of judgment and in heaven, inshallah ta'ala. Hada walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wassalatu wassalamu ala Muhammadin wa alihi at-tayyibin at-tahirin.